online, znači vidimo Karolinu Spaic, vid teatr iz Holandije. Karolina, mahni ako nas čuješ. Tako je, čuje nas Karolina. I imamo, treba da se pojavi uskoro Violeta Luna iz Sjedinjenih Američkih Država, to jest Meksika. Violeta, hello, Violeta, I'm just introducing you. Nadam se da nas čuje.
Hello, Dijana.
Okay, fantastic.
I'm here.
I will summarize in English sometimes.
Hello, Carolina. Nice to meet you.
Beautiful. Hello. Yes. Hello.
I'm here.
Hello.
I didn't hear Diana. That Diana says, I don't know, that she was talking about the order, or
I also didn't understand, honestly.
Okay.
It's hard. It's not really. How are you?
I'm good. Where are you?
I'm in Amsterdam.
From where?
You hear us, Violeta.
Diana, how are you?
I'm fine, and we are sitting here. We have a audience. It's just after performance of Jadranka, and I was introducing yourself, Karolina. And I continue to introduce tonight's speakers, and then I talk in English from time to time because of, that you can understand, okay?
Yes, exactly.
Okay, and then it's your turn. I will ask you to talk. Okay,
yes.
But everyone, please say hello to Violeta.
Hello.
And Carolina. Bravo, Carolina.
Ciao. And we will turn off our cameras, and then when we start, we turn off.
Can you repeat, please?
We can turn off our cameras, and then when we start, we turn on.
Yes, you can talk first. Not your video, but we have three speakers right now. Then okay. Carolina, then yourself, okay? And you see and hear us, yes? Okay,
yes.
Fantastic. I'm amazed.
No, we don't see you.
I don't see you.
No,
Dijana.
We don't see you, Dijana.
But you hear.
Yes, but you don't see.
Okay, good. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Rekla, autorka večerašnjeg performansa, rediteljka, suosnivačica DAH teatra, Ljubica Damčević, muzičarka, performerka, profesorka muzike, tangoista i još mnogo toga, saradnica DAH teatra i drugih umetničkih kolektiva, Gordana Vukašin, koordinatorka direktne pomoći, jer tako, i... toga pedagoškinja i saradnica grupe 484. Mi smo se skupili da pričamo o ovom fenomenu, a to je presađivanje ljudi. Videli smo večeras u ovom divnom, nežnom performansu analogiju između presađivanja biljaka i presađivanja ljudi. Šta to znači, koliko je nege i nežnosti potrebno da se ljudi ponovo presade u novu sredinu. Tako da će moje prvo pitanje Jadranki biti šta je bio povod uopšte za ovaj performans, van toga što je naravno Jadranka i deo tima koji je organizovao ovaj festival. Ona je sama predložila ovu temu, pa me zanima naravno da nam kaže za osnovnu, koja je njena osnovna motivacija. Ja ću sada samo da prevedem. Da li ja mogu da prevedem zbog Violete? Mogu? Zlatko? Mogu. Violeta, you hear me, yes? I just introduced all speakers, I mean live speakers, and then I introduce yourself and Karolina. I was introducing Jadranka because tonight's performance, Terra, or Earth, or Zemlja in our language, was related to the phenomena of the plants that need to transplantation of plants as analogy to transplantation of people, and how much care, tenderness, and love it takes to transplant someone from different culture and different country. So I will from time to time just summarize for you what are we talking about. So now Jadranka will talk on the topic of what was her main motivation for this performance.
Dobro večer. Ja mislim da je ideja za performans se rodila u jednom momentu kada sam ja gledala jedan dokumentarni film u kome su emigranti već bili recimo u Nemačkoj ili Austriji, nekoj od tih zemalja, koji su cilj migracije u poslednjih godina. I kada je neki tamo službenik, birokrata, nešto tamo govorio, to je bio jedan kratak blic, kako to biva onako u životu, jedan moment rodi mnogo toga, jel? I on je nešto određivao gde će koji, i odjednom je jedan čovek počeo da viče užasnut, bolno, da urla, ali ne da urla zbog nasilno, nego očajno. Pa ne možete to da nam radite, pa ne možete tako da nas razdvajate, pa ne možete tako da nas odvajate. I ja sam imala taj stvarno osjećaj tog, te arogancije naše, koje mi često imamo prema biljkama, prema tom nekom pejzažizmu i druge vrste, ne samo biljke. Biljke su došle možda pošto sam ono, razmišljala o tome, ali ukratko to nasilje takog, tog recimo planskog pejzažizma sa ljudima mi je u tom momentu prosto onako eksplodiralo. I eto, slučajno se sećam, nekada mi čovek i ne zna zašto je nešto smislio, ali mislim da se stvarno u tom momentu odjednom se desilo nešto i osjetila sam, videla sam tu sliku jednostavno, da neko tako lagodno, kako mi lagodno sadimo biljke, lagodno i kupujemo, pa presađujemo, pa ne sviđa nam se, pa stavimo ovde, pa kad uvene kupimo drugu, koji je problem, imamo u svakom samoposluzi. I onda taj neki odnos koji imamo prema biljkama, koji nije idealan, iako se mi trudimo, koji nije odnos zapravo prave brige, tako možete, mislim, takav odnos prelazi na ljude još gore, jel? Radi se, znači, o nečemu što bi mi imali, trebali da imamo još više saosećanja, iako je to diskutabilno. Ali, dakle, eto, to je bio neki flash, stvarno, neka moment kada se rodila ideja. I onda, naravno, imamo festival koji apsolutno govori o tome i, naravno, dalje razvijali, ali, eto da kažem, neka dvostruka, ne samo što ljude tretiramo loše i prirodu, tretiramo loše ceo prirodni svet. Dalaj Lama je jednom rekao da se osjećanje treba da počnemo da vežbamo od životinja. Tako da ceo taj naš moment u kome živimo, ovaj trenutak, ima puno pitanja, puno preispitivanja kako živeti, kako ta briga, prema kome, prema čemu sve, prema našoj planeti kao celini. A ova situacija migracije se ponavlja i ponavlja, i ono, s tim bi završila da ne bi dugo pričali. Forma performansa je izašla iz potrebe da kažemo nešto jednostavno, da bi možda takvom jednostavnošću i dotakli publiku koja je već prepuna informacija. Jer, dakle, pitali smo se, dobro, kako je moguće godinama živimo sabe, ove nove poslednje godine, znači novu ovu migraciju, da kažemo od Sirije ovamo. Istorija je migracija i tako dalje, ali sve ove informacije, sve ove vesti, sve ovo što slušamo na tako dalje, news, u novinski izveštaj, ne deluju. Jer očigledno da ono osnovno i najbitnije, to je saosećanje i briga, ne funkcioniše. Bez toga, apsolutno, nikada nećemo imati pravih mera ili zaštite. Tako, bez toga ne postoji ništa. Ostalo je sve slovo na papiru ili neki zakon koji je donesen. Kao što vrlo dobro znamo, zakon ne znači mnogo.
Okay, I'll try to summarize briefly, and also we have Eveline Costa here in the audience, our Brazilian guest, so I think that's also good for her to hear. But what Jadranka said basically was that the intention of the performance was to wake up the care, and that her first impulse was seeing the one migrant saying in some situation that he was almost crying and screaming, like, you can't do this to us, meaning like you can't just take us, like to translate us from one place to another. And Jadranka compared it with our carelessness about plants, and that we think that we own plants and we can just plant it and then transplant it and then throw it away and so on. And she quoted Dalai Lama, who said that our compassion basically really starts from our taking care about the animals. And that this performance was intentionally very simple because we have already too much of everything, and even for all our media and news and everything that we use, we can't transmit what is really needed today, and this is compassion and care. So in short, Jadranka spoke much more eloquently, but this is in short. Ok, znači, Ljubice, volala bih tebe da pitam kao performerku i muzičarku u ovom komadu, zašto izbor ove muzike, odakle je došao izbor ove muzike. Ti naravno božanstveno pevaš i pesme su na određenim jezicima, tako da mene zanima šta to tebi lično znači i kako ste došle ti, Jadranka, ili ti do ovih pesma.
Dobro veče. Svakako bazirali smo izbor muzike na arapskoj muzici, italijanskoj. Ubacili smo isto jevrejsku muziku. I arapske migracije koje su trenutno aktuelne. Zatim, one su nas prosto inspirisale i ova divna pesma Lama Bada, koja je veoma poznata, ali možda čak potiče iz Španije, odnosno od jednog arapskog kompozitora iz 14. veka, tako da i ta pesma je prešla raznorazne kontinente i ona je, kako da kažem, migrirala, da. Tako da smo tražili neke pesme koje su pre svega lepe, koje su pre svega nama interesantne i koje osjećamo, a pritom je bilo važno, znači, koji jezik je u pitanju, da je arapski, zatim italijanski, postoje čak tri italijanske pesme u performansu zbog italijanskih migracija sa kraja 19. veka i početkom 20. veka i tokom 20. veka. I naravno jevrejska, kao jevreji narod koji nikad nema zapravo svoj dom. Tako da izbor muzike se naravno sveo na te tradicionalne pesme naroda koji su tokom istorije dosta migrirali. I uklopili smo ih, naravno, značenje reči u kontekst, da ja verujem da nisu svi razumeli. Možda italijanski neko, ali negde osjećamo šta neka pesma znači. Tako da ne treba da znamo sad intelektualno šta, kako prevod ide. Nekako se osjeti i ovaj, tražili smo znači, da tekst pesama bude isto u kontekstu i u sceni i u performansu. Tako da.
Hvala, Ljubice. Now I'll summarize for Violeta and Evelini. And basically what was my question was, why was this choice of music? And this choice of music, Ljubica said, was, first of all, the music was Italian, Arabic and Jewish, because those were the people that migrated a lot, and that Jewish people are still, like, in a way, migrating. That the text of the songs was, of course, for them important. And then they counted on emotional effect on us. Even if we didn't understand the language, we could understood it through emotions. But obviously, the text was dramaturgically important for the show. And that was the main, basically, reason for this kind of the choice of the music.
Znači kulture ove koji ajde kažem koje migriraju, migracije koje znamo, a u slučaju jevrejske muzike naravno ono što mi mislimo ne znači da i publika također doživljava, a u slučaju jevrejske scene tu imamo i dvostranost, jel? Tu smo mi, a to ne znači i vi, nekada razmišljaju o tome kao, eto, jevrejski narod toliki hiljada godina je bio nomad, a sada možda neki drugi narod tretira kao nekog koga treba presaditi. Tako da u celoj predstavi nije samo ono lepo i kao dobro, mi smo divni, mi sad ove biljke, nego to je prosto dvostrano. Nismo mi, nekada i želimo da budemo dobri, ali ne uspevamo, ja? Tako da imamo dve strane i baš u toj sceni ima ta dvostrukost. Nekada govorimo o nekoj nostalgiji, nekog, ajde da kažemo, iz nekog dalekog istoka, a nekad pomislimo na nešto dvostruko.
Pošto je Ljubica spomenula izbor, naravno, arapske muzike, ovo što ste dobili, to su rečnici, sigurno ste videli, arapsko-srpski, persijsko-srpski, koje je organizacija Balkanski centar za migracije štampala. I mi mislimo da je to jedan mali doprinos širenju kulture, povezivanja, zato što je važno da znamo jezike jednih drugih i arapski i persijski jezik su drevni jezici i svakako možemo samo da obogatimo našu kulturu, kao što je naravno važno za ljude koji dolaze iz tih zemalja da mogu da dobiju ove rečnike i da se snađu u našem društvu, tako da ovo je naš mali poklon za publiku.
I just said Violeta that we were speaking about the music and the choice of the music that was also Arabic, we also gave out to the audience the examples of the dictionaries, Persian, Serbian and Arabic Serbian dictionaries printed by one organization here, with the wish that we enrich our culture with these languages, as also migrants would need to learn our language. And also what Jadranka said, speaking about Jewish music, that it was not only in one way that we are just speaking about beautiful things and so on, but also Jewish people are maybe translating some other people today, as we all know what is the conflict there. And so this was also something that they wanted to touch in the performance. So my next question will be directed to our third live guest. I mean, you're also live, but I mean alive, but not and so, but here physically with us, Gordana Vukašin. Goco, ja znam da ti već godinama radiš u okviru grupe 484, koja je zaista fantastična organizacija sa kojom je Dah teatar sarađivao puno puta i zanima me, znam da puno radite sa migrantima,
da radite u migrantskim centrima i tako dalje. I zanima me šta je opet tvoj lični impuls za tu vrstu angažmana?
Dobro večer svima. Kao prvo, grupa 484, prvo da kažem nešto o organizaciji, organizacija koja postoji već 25 godina. I sada kad razmišljam o ovom kontekstu u glavi mi je kada ljudi dođu u našu zemlju, sad taj tretman koji mi pružamo nekako kroz našu organizaciju jeste da taj moment da ponegujemo njihovo to otrgnuto korenje koji dolazi kroz program direktne podrške o kom radim ja i moje kolege, o kojoj su neki ovde u publici. Zatim da kroz program mi i oni drugi pokušavamo da utičemo na tu zemlju u koju pokušavamo na neki način da ih malo bolje integrišemo, da menjamo neke vrednosti, naročito vrednosti kod mladih i na kraju krajeva da kroz naš treći program, Centar za migracije, utičemo na te neke politike koje ipak treba da poboljšaju na neki dugoročniji način položaj tih ljudi u našem društvu. Sad, što se tiče mog ličnog, lične želje za rad sa ljudima koji dolaze iz tih nama dalekih i u neku ruku ono, i egzotičnih zemalja jeste što ja sama sa neke strane delim to migrantsko iskustvo i prosto nisam iz Srbije, došla sam iz druge zemlje i to mi je nekako primarno bio motiv kad sam krenula da radim sa institucijama.
Koje je tvoje iskustvo kao nekoga ko je došao iz druge zemlje ovde? Šta ti je bilo teško, šta ti je bilo važno, šta ti je bilo od pomoći?
Mislim, to je nešto što je ono bilo poprilično davno, ali zapravo to prihvatanje sa osjećanje ljudi koje smo dobijali i to je ono generalno što mi pokušavamo da probudimo kroz naš rad, što terenski rad, što rad u lokalnim zajednicama, jeste da zapravo probudimo to sa osjećanje ljudi, razumevanje ljudi, da pored toga što da, na prvi pogled izgledaju nam kao nepoznati, daleki ljudi koji su došli iz zemalja o kojima samo čitamo i sa kojima imamo jako malo dodira i iskustva, ali sa druge strane te neke emocije koje zajednički koje delimo na kraju krajeva to je nešto situacija u kojoj svako od nas može da se nađe i kad se prepozna ta neka emocija, mislim da nam je onda lakše da ih razumemo i da im pružimo i to saosećanje i tu empatiju koja im je neophodna na ovom putu. Bilo da će ostati ovde i da će se integrisati, da će ih ova zemlja prihvatiti i ponegovati ili će prosto biti samo jedna od stanica na njihovom putu dalje ka Evropi i nekom boljem životu, gde su opet očekivanja koje imaju pitanje koliko dodiru sa realnošću, ali opet jeste nešto čemu oni teže i nadaju se da će tamo naći neku bolju budućnost.
Hvala. I will summarize now. Again, this is I asked Goca, who works for the group, which name is Group 484, that works for 25 years, and a lot deals with the migrations and migrants. And basically, Gordana herself had a migrant experience because she came from another country, so she could identify what is the need of the people coming here. And to summarize, the incredible work that 484 is doing is basically really to somehow wake up the compassion and the care of the local people in Serbia towards the migrants, towards the people that are coming. This is, let's say, one line of activities. Another line of activities is to integrate young people into our society, to help them integrate more. So please jump in if I say anything wrong. But overall, what is the most important in their work is really to wake up the acceptance and compassion of the people, because Serbia is in a specific situation that migrants are coming here only for the limited
time because it's transition towards the so-called Western Europe, where they would hope they would find the home there and so on. And so even that it is transition, it is very important station for them, and it is important that they get the care basically they need, because very often I like the image Goethe used, their roots are somehow torn apart, and then they need really to heal their roots in the new surroundings and then to continue from here. Okay, I Karolina, da li si sa nama?
Jesam, jesam, evo me, čekaj, da su...
Karolina, da li...
Jesam, jesam, jel ne vidite me?
Super. Karolina Spaic.
Jeste. Jel me vidite? Yes. Ćao, Dijana.
Priča o tome, o fantastičnom radu koji radi, koji je dobio mnogo nagrada do sada. Karolina lično je dobila sada jednu jako veliku nagradu od ove kraljice, ako se ne varam, Holandije, i njihov rad je Holandije i mnogih drugih zemalja. Znači, Karolina, izvoli. Violeta, I just introduced Karolina, and Karolina will speak about her work about with Zied Theater in Amsterdam. You maybe remember that Zied means wall. So maybe, Karolina, I can ask you to start, why that name?
This is a long time ago. Do you hear me? You want me to speak in Serbian? Do you hear me?
Da li neko ne razume? Vrlo rado da prevodimo. You can speak in English, Karolina, if it is okay.
Okay, this is fine. So, hello from Amsterdam. Is it okay? Sound? Hello from Amsterdam. I'm the director of the Zied Theater. And Dijana asked, why Zied Theater? I don't know. Everybody wants to talk with me now. Zied Theater is based in Amsterdam for a very long time ago. Actually, professionally, we work for 1992. But I don't know what is with my line. Doesn't work well. I don't understand.
We hear you, Karolina.
Yes, but I don't know. I see myself, but you don't see me.
We see you also.
Ah, okay. So my picture on the YouTube is a little bit later. So, we are working from 92 in Amsterdam. And Zied means wall in Serbian, as you know. So we made this name I gave when I was really a teenager in Belgrade working with theater. And it means for us breaking the walls between people, between the concepts of art, between the professionals and not professionals, in general means to connect on different ways through art. And we worked in that very long time, so from 92. And I want to connect with your subject about migration and about situation now. Because in one way, Amsterdam is very proud that we have the 180 nationalities of people living together on such a small space in a small city. And because we have a million people and it's 180 nationalities, 80. So it's very much. And in the same time, it is challenging. It is not easy. And it also means that... all of us have to open a lot of doors. And it means also that beside the society, that is the first thing. The second thing is how to implement all these people, talents, cultures in art. And this has been the mission of Zied Theater for more than 20 years. And we always try to be very much up to date in the sense what are we making, who is our public, and who are the artists that work with us. So our group of artists that work with us, actors, dancers, designers, they are all coming from different countries. We don't have 180 nationalities, but we have a lot. As we are really what we want also to represent in art, all different voices and all different, how you say, the cultures, but not in a way, multicultural way, but an artistic way also, to present from a different points of view, cultural points of view, heritage points of view, the art. And so we have now the Festival Explorers that we also say we create space for new art forms. And we are very much busy with the subject of migration, as we got a lot of new people here from Syria, from Palestine, from Eritrea. A lot of people came last 3-4 years to stay here. And we have some of them are working with us. We have really fantastic dancers from this part of the world. But the continuous process of creating the dialogue between people and authorities of art and the new people that are coming is really a challenge, and it will be a challenge for a long time. So this is maybe the what I would like to say now.
Thank you, Karolina. And just to ask you about the new Fate project that we are going to collaborate. So maybe you can just say a few sentences, why Fate and what does it mean?
Fate is a new project that we just started, and we are very happy that Dach Theater is one of 5 partners, together with the Atalaya Theater from Sevilla, Studio 7 from Germany, and University of Torino, SET from Torino, from Italy. And the main subject of this project is to create possibilities, methodologies, and ways to involve these newcomers, either they are refugees or migrants of different ways, in the cultural life of the countries. As we have very much people that are really settled here, and Spain also, we chose to work first with the groups of a group of people in Amsterdam and in Sevilla, and we chose that all 5 partners will be involved to develop methodology for the future, and to think really about how these people can be really good representatives of a new way of new culture, new art forms that are very important, because this is the first generation that is coming now, sometimes second. And then from now on, there will be a lot of young new people and kids that will be born here and with the roots somewhere else. And how we incorporate all this in theatrical and in art life in our countries.
Carolina, this is something that reminds me to the work that Group 48 is doing. 484 is doing, so who knows, maybe we can make very interesting connections. By the way, this is the program which name is Connections, that is funded by a Goethe-Institut Relief Fund, and this is very important to mention, not only because it's obligatory, of course, for us, but because from the heart it's one foundation that recognizes the need of artists to and the necessity to work in these times of pandemic, where basically our art is almost impossible to get funds because it's live art. And this is something that we have in this collaboration and project, which one activity is Connections, but we'll speak about that more. Karolina, do you have some video? Maybe at the end you can show the video, but I'm just checking.
Yes, we have the short piece of our latest performance. It's called Odyssey, and it's also based on migration stories of different people, but also of the actors that are in the performance. So I will not say very much. You can see the performance, and performance should open Nashville Jazz Festival this year. But because everything was cancelled, I hope that you will come with the performance next year. to open the festival.
We hope to. So I will now ask Violeta to talk, and then at the end, and to show her work, and then at the end you can show your work. We are just under the time restriction because of the measures due to the COVID. So I'm taking care about time. That's my role tonight. I mean, apart of others. Violeta, hello again. And so Violeta Luna, performance artist, activist, body artist. She's from coming from Mexico, living in San Francisco, working with a very interesting artistic collectives as Pocha Nostra, Secos y Mojados, many others, and having incredible work, body of work that travels the world. So, Violeta, hello, welcome. It's great to see you. And I would like to ask you, because you being Mexican, coming to US and living in US, which contains contradictions already because of the relationship between Mexico immigrants and US, how did you find the way to communicate this contradiction through your art?
I think in the first, I just want to say thank you, Dijana, for inviting me to be with you and with the people that is my family. I think that the art is very important tool to create a contra narratives for the narratives who came from the power to say that the immigrant is the represent the enemy in the society. As an immigrant living in the US, I feel the important to talk through not just through the art, but also through the body. I mean, to incorporate in the performance actors, social actors that embody all these very violent narratives that came from the power about to stigmatize the immigrants. No, I feel that the performance art is a very strong tool because it's has different windows to approach to the audience and also to invite the audience to have an active role in the piece, no, but not just in the piece, but also in the life, and to act and every decision that the audience do in the performance piece, for example, has a repercussion, and also this is in the life. Every decision that they do with the immigrants has a repercussion.
Can you tell us a little bit more about the situation right now with Mexican immigrants to US? Because we know a little bit, but I know that you are very concerned and many other artists that are working around that topic. So could you tell us a little bit more about the situation and what do you do in relation to that?
And also I will read a very short paragraph that reflects the question that you asked me, because I will present the project Border Triptych that is about immigration. But we developed this piece from 2008, 2014. And all the ideas and all the concept that we work are very vigilant, and also even worse, because the climate is very cruelty.
Hello,
I will
Ik hoop dat ik heb een conferentie in Belgrado waar ik gast van ben.
Oh.
Dus,
ze hoort me praten, joh.
Oh.
Okay, you can go on.
I say the current abusive immigration policies, the lack of immigration reform project, had made a lot of worse the living and working condition of our communities. Right-wing politicians are promoting organized crime hysteria scenarios to build their war, stigmatizing the Latinx body as a criminal, as legalizing ethnic profiling practices. We ask, how does an illegal body look like? How does law enforcement identify it? In the eye of the racist, are no difference between criminal and undocumented, or a Latino worker, citizen or not. I mean, all the narratives that is constructed about that the immigrant is the enemy of the society, is our communities is the target. And now all the people of color, like black people, brown people, indigenous people, we are the target for this government that always create not just is the narrative, but also all the structure created to punish, create a very bad concept about to be immigrant.
Do you maybe have some video to share with us?
Yeah. I will share the few images of this border trip that is through three different parts. One part is about when the immigrants decide to leave her country, and the second one is when we focus when she arrived in the US, and the third part is about the idea of the home and belonging. I can share a few images, and also I just open for the audience if they have questions, because maybe sometimes the images speak more clear than I.
So you can show us now. You can use the share screen, yeah?
I think that Diana, I sent.
Yes. I just got the information.
Share.
Okay.
I think that the panelists talk about all the topic that is in the work. I mean, all the idea to the compassion and tenderness when we receive people who came from different country, and also what happened as an immigrant when you decide to leave your country and to live in the new one, and how you transform in the society, and also to create different narrative that the immigrant is not just a worker, because sometimes people think that they came just to work, but we are also a creative person that we can create different dramaturgies, through the art, for example. And for my work is always important to include to community members in the work. And also you will see in the images, son of actors that came from different communities, like the labor program, LGBTQ community, para trans Latinas, women's collectives, that I always try to create a relationship, not just for the art, but also to be connected with my community.
So let's see the images. So Vladan will play it, yes? Okay.
I don't see, because it has a sounds, and I think that is important to hear the sound, because it's the poem of the Roque Dalton, the Salvadorian poet, about about to be immigrant.
Looking at images, and we hear the music.
Sabe nadie de dónde son. Evo sad pogledamo što zašto ne znači. Možemo, možemo, nego samo da vidimo.
Ali imam sam danu da je napišem, da ćemo dopustimo video koji je pita i da
završimo
ovo.
Ok, ok. Dobre. Dobre, že? Ovako ćemo.
Little boy, 4 years old, 5 years old, is standing in the sea and he's waiting for
Marte y se fue al agua.
They come close, and then he...
Tražio sam im. Aga.
Karolina, čujemo?
Da, čujemo se, da.
E, sjajno. Videli smo sada da se vaš grada i grada vida i hvala puno. Ovo je bilo zaista strašno zanimljivo vidjeti jedan drugi grada, jedan koji drugo, svoji violeti, to je vaši violeti. Mi imamo jako malo vremena, pa nećemo imati vremena za pitanja iz publike, ali ovo je početak jedne konverzacije i nadamo se da se vidimo uskoro u Beogradu.
Hvala i vama. Puno uspeha sa festivalom, bravo.
Hvala. Violeta, you hear us? Could you unmute yourself, Violeta?
Okay.
I'm sorry, it was a little complicated to I couldn't hear you, but
we are in fact doing great because we saw the
over
and
we saw
the first one. Sorry, it was a little bit.
And now
we are running out of time, so we will have to say goodbye. And
big thank you. And we hope to keep in touch
and
seeing and representing each other.
I really can delay.
Because it's a view of culture, very national view of culture. So the huge challenge, we are talking about involving immigrants, people from other cultures, and actually can express themselves. And how this make peace, this traditional idea that we have Serbian culture, old culture, many cultures, etc., etc. And this is a huge tension, and this lasted for a long time already now. And I don't see really thinking like multicultural societies, intercultural understanding. I see still it's a really huge gap notion of like, if you only think like we're talking about Serbian culture. And suddenly maybe one Pakistani or country is here to bring something new. So this is the how to think about culture and all other things in the life.
Da, sad ja.
Možda možemo da ostavimo još malo, da pustimo na kraju. Vlada, da li možemo da vidimo poslednji klip, to je Ipsterofobija, tema iz naš predstavljeni grad. Želimo da sastavimo ovo večer.
Hallo. Guten Tag alles. Was bin ich? Nicole. Ksenofobija, od grčkih reči ksenos, što znači stranac, i fobos, što znači strah, je snažna, iracionalna mržnja i nepoverenje prema strancima, njihovim običajima, vrednostima i navikama. Ich komme aus Dresden. U Vranju. Ich finde meine Liebe. Sviram bubnje u jednom funk bandu.
Sekvencija.